Hello everyone. Today I will introduce you about the fiber splicer, how to calibrate the OPM function. And when you use the machine, you found that this OPM function have a big loss between AI's OPM device. So we need to do a calibrate about it. The first thing is that we need to prepare one OTDR and one fiber jump cable. These tools for us to provide a stable light source, the OTDR source, light source, and we plug it into the light source socket. The second thing is select the correct wavelength. You can see that 1310. It shows you that turn off. We need to turn on it. Turn on it. Check the page of the OPM test. So we plug it into the OPM socket. Okay, so you can check that. The OPM tests the fiber jumper loss. This is the true loss, 1.23. So we need to remember this value because this is a standard value. We mark it on the paper. Okay, so put it aside. The second thing is that we take out the OPM socket of the fiber jumper and put it into the machine side. Remember, need to put it in the OPM socket. The second thing is we open the cover lips so that we can turn on the OPM function buttons. So open it, then press the power button and select the wavelength to 1310. And the second button is select the wavelength. You can check it. We must ensure that the light source wavelength is same like the test wavelength. Okay. You can check that 1310 and it's same. So we have connected, but you can see that the light source is 1.26 and what of us is 1.23. So we calibrate it. The first thing, connect to the machine app. Okay, so we have connect to the machine app and we press the OPM VFL page. So you can see there, measuring tube calibration, the standard power. We have marked that the standard power is 1.23, so we fill with the value into this box, 1.23, so save it. Okay, so you can check that after you press the save button and it will give you a feedback. So when the machine you have test, so this machine we have calibrated very well, and when you test it, you will find that the value is not same like the 1.23. It may be 10 point or 20 point. That's very big dislocation. So we need to do the machine OPM function calibration. This is what we can help you make the OPM function work well for you. So today is introduced about the OPM function calibration. What else? If you met a bus machine, please contact us and feel free.